Right then, so we've just been talking to the farmer there because I was walking back from the Court Farms because we're doing a contract over there now. We're just about to go and do it. And I've decided, like, we're not contractors, right? We're... Oh, no. It's now raining. Okay, so I've just dropped the potato harvester over there to a potato harvest contract. But I've decided we're not contractors. We're not. You know, we've set up to do farming as farmers on a farm. So we've had some good news. I mean, he's lucky these sheep don't get out over here. About the money that Sam had basically stolen off of us. So we've been fighting a legal battle with it, and we have got over half of it back, which means that Sam is now out on the look. They're looking out for her to try and claim it back. So yeah, we've got quite a bit of money now that we can start fresh over here. Well, I say start fresh over here. I don't want to start too fresh over here. Because I think, well, I have on the grapevine that there's a farm coming back at home. And, yeah, I want to move back up there. So, what I'm going to do in the meantime till it is, excuse me, is I am going to turn our little yard into a nice little, like a small holding. So we'll have some animals on it and things like that. But like I was saying to the farm back there, the access to it is just a nightmare. It would be really good if we had the plot next to us, because that looks like it used to be part of it. And he turned around and he said, well, it did. He said, but they sold it. And he bought it. So he actually owns the plot next to us. And has agreed, not this one, sell it to us, and also the plot behind us. So what it was is the person that owned all three of them come into financial difficulty, so sold this plot here, which he's going to sell to us. So he's pretty much said we can start using it now as ours. So if I open that, so come off the road lane into here. All right, we got a nice, like, little sweeping thing. Then we got a nice field down here, and we're buying it with the crop in it, so we will own the crop. And then, this is the best bit, it goes down here, which I was doing a lot of sorting out on the farm and I noticed it. So, we'll take that fence down and we'll have a better access road into it. Now, like I was saying, they sold this farm up. They sold this plot of land up to him and the one behind us, because they come into financial difficulty. Now, they had a deal that as long as he owned the land, that they would have right of access into their plot. because obviously, as we know, the access down here is very poor. But they tried to do some clever stuff and get away without paying taxes. So they actually sold it to their brother to start with. So obviously it then changed hands. So it didn't belong to him. So he didn't have to keep up the right of access. He then also started becoming a pain. So he was just right. You no longer have right of access, which it was up to him to do. So, like I was saying, oh, it's a tap there. I've never noticed that, but then I suppose I've not walked here. So, I've started clearing. As you can see, all the rubbish has gone from here. I've cut a load of trees down. So, yeah, I've cut a lot of trees down, which are in there, and cleared this way. So, we're going to turn this into, and I've started doing it already, look, a little small holding with animals and, you know, but we've got the field there now, and if we come down here, so we've got all this land here, it goes all the way down here. And they used to have pigs, which I've not really walked down here. So they got pigs. Well, they did have pigs there. And then that field there is now going to be ours as well. So we'll take these fences down as well. So we're going to have those two fields extra. So with the money we've got from the bank, we're going to be able to do quite a bit. Now, like I said, I took on a contract. I'm not one of these to then turn it down. But this will be our last contract. But also, the old man at the farm is giving up the doing farming. So he needs to find a place for his cows. So I said, keep hold of them. We'll go up, feed them and look after them. At no charge. And then once we've done our farm upgrades, we will buy them off of him. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to go into a bit of beef cattle and buy them off of him. So quite a few. Hey, up. Why have I? There's actually diesel, silage additive, and then, what's that, herbicide? Why did I never notice this? I thought it was just, and fur, jeez, okay, that shed's going, we just put them somewhere else, this little shed thing's going, and yeah, we're going to do a massive upgrade. So after this episode, I'm gonna get on busy doing all the farmyard, the farm work and stuff. So there won't be a video until I've done it all. But this rain is annoying. So I'm gonna go in and have a coffee and wait until it dies off. Right then, just finished the coffee. The rain did not stop yesterday. So, we've got up early. And we are going to go and do this harvest. So, that's the attach, that's the attach. Let's start our up. Let's keeper running. Look at that. That's, you know, looking nice. Think she's going to be a really good workhorse. So, could have taken the Fent, I suppose, but, you know, for that size trailer, we don't really need it. You know, this little one will do it. So, let's get going to do this harvest. Now, they obviously understood that it was raining yesterday and I couldn't go and do it. They said don't rush in today. But I just basically want to get it done. So, what I'm going to do is, so what we do is, at the moment we come out of it, we go right. Even when we're going left, and then with obviously their permission, we've asked, it's fine, we come in and swing around. And go back. Right, so here we go, off to go and do the harvest. Gorgeous morning here. I love the sunrise. So, I'll see you in the field doing the harvest. Taken a few hours. It's now 12:59. So we started about 7:30 this morning. It's now 12:59. As you can see, I'm now in our Fent because that master just did not have the power to tote is full of potatoes. So I went and got our fennel. And to be fair, as you would expect, so much barrenness, it did not struggle one bit. So I dropped the last load off to where we're dropping it, and they said, well, you've completed the requirement for what we've asked for. So we actually get the money for this one, apparently, which is all good. So, yeah, we should get a bit extra money on top of what they're paying for us. Must admit, it's a bit weird. It was a bit weird being on the farm that my grandpa used to own and we used to own. But, you know, that is what it is. Hopefully I'm not here for too long. I can move back up to near Gloucester, near home. And, yeah, get my life settled up there, near family. And, yeah, be back on a nice farm. There's one apparently coming up for sales soon, so just keeping a listen out for it. So, yeah, hopefully not too long. It's time now we went back to... I'm sure that used to be like a transport yard. When that used to be a transport yard where I used to work. About there. Oh. They obviously didn't last. Or gone somewhere else, bigger and better. Pub. Could do with a pint. So. Let's get this now back to our little yard. And I think what we're going to do then is, I'm not thinking of doing potatoes ourselves. So what I think we might then do is, apparently Chimp, you know, the scrap man, is still around. So we'll go down and have a look at him, see how much he's going to offer for that. And look at some different equipment, because we're going to need some equipment to run the farm. Well, small holding. So, yeah, get back, get planning, and get building. And the next time you'll see me, we should have a nice little small holding. So, until next time, love you, bye.